morning, Red Lion Area Junior High School. It is August 24th, and we are finally all in the building together. Today is the first day for both 7th and 8th graders combined, and I have one really small request for you today. Help each other out. Look, the hallways are going to be crowded, people are going to be confused and lost, and don't even get me started on lockers and combinations. So, if you see someone struggling today, ask if he can help. And who knows, you might become besties with that person that you help. So, small request today, help each other. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. This is WLIN News, and here is your daily school information. Today is a cycle day 3. Hey, Meet the Teacher Night is tonight from 6 to 8, so don't forget to remind your parents, because you know parents, they're always forgetting things. Ugh. Are you interested in joining the morning announcements? There will be an informational meeting next Monday during ROAR. And speaking of meetings, there will be a boys basketball meeting in Mr. Flay's room on Thursday during ROAR. Last one about clubs and meetings. Don't forget, Minithon Club is open to 7th and 8th grade students. Applications are due, though, by September 9th for the kids. So, it's a brand new year, guys. I know there's a lot of changes going on, 7th grade, 8th grade. Even if you've been here before, there's new things going on. So, here to explain a little bit more of one of those changes, our hall passes for this year, we have Mr. Beal and Dr. Landis. So, I will turn it over to them.
Thank you, Mr. Bell, for that wonderful introduction.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Bell. Good morning, students. We are here to talk to you about your new pass. Yes, exciting stuff.
Yes, it is.
So, as Mr. Bell said, there are some changes happening here, and one of those changes is that every marking period you will receive something that looks like this, but it will be on cardstock. It will be color-coded. 8th grade will have a different color than 7th grade so that we know which floor you should be on. And there will be approximately 3 pass slots on average per day for you to use. This must be with you if you are going anywhere in the building, with the exception of during lunch and during gym. We do not want you to bring this to lunch or to gym. It needs to stay in your locker or backpack at lunch and in your gym locker or hall locker at gym time, because we don't want you to lose it.
I have a question, Dr. Landis.
Yes.
What happens if I drop, lose, or rip mine, if something happens to my pass?
You know what, Mr. Beal, that is a really great question. While I would expect you to be responsible with your very important pass sheet, I also understand that things happen, and there might be a situation where you spill your water on your pass.
I love water.
I love water, too. Or you lose it, the dog ate it, whatever the story is. You can come to the office and we will give you another.
We get all those days over again?
No, Mr. Beal. You don't get all those days over again. If we're 2 weeks into the marking period, we're going to cross off 2 weeks worth of pass slots.
That just seems fair.
Yeah, it's fair.
Okay.
But, Mr. Beal, I need you to be responsible with the new one I give you, because if you keep losing them or spilling your water on them, I'm not going to give you another. Actually, I lie. I am going to give you another, but I'm going to probably also give you a lunch detention for being irresponsible.
Also seems very fair.
So, but I know that you're going to be responsible with your sheet.
If I have any questions, who else can I look out to?
About this sheet?
Yes.
Oh, if you have questions, you can always come to me.
Okay.
If I have questions, can I come to you?
Yes, you can.
You could also ask your teachers. You could ask your counselors. There are lots of people in the building you can ask. But this is our new pass sheet system. Your teachers will probably explain more to you about it today when they give it to you. But again, this must be kept with you, and you will get a new one each marking period.
Thank you.
You know what, Mr. Bale?
Yes.
I'm kind of feeling some type of way about the fact that you got to do the words of wisdom yesterday. So I'm going to do them today.
Yes, ma'am. Anything you would like.
Thank you. I knew you'd see it my way. Good morning, Red Lion Area Junior High. This is Dr. Landis with a few words of wisdom. Every year, farmers around the globe plow their fields, plant their seeds, and then harvest their crops. Their crops feed their families and, in fact, feed families all around the world. Each year, these same farmers make a choice. This is what a group of Virginia farmers has to say about it. We have a choice: to plow new ground or to let the weeds grow. So what's that got to do with you? Well, it's simple. You have a choice too. You can plow new ground this year at school, plant seeds of knowledge and wisdom, and then reap all the rewards of a good education, or you can sit back and just let the weeds grow. What's it going to be? With something to think about, this is Dr. Landis. Make it a great day, or not, the choice is yours.
As always, boys and girls, make good choices and learn something new.
Work it, make it, do it, makes us all the better, faster, stronger. That
don't kill me, can only make us stronger. I need you to hurry up, man.